lovely day over in Centennial Gardens. That's, of course, Herman Park, folks. Welcome back to Houston Life. So today we've been chatting about sun, its harmful effects, and now we're chatting about sunscreen. With so many options and different price points, how do you know what's best to protect your skin?
Dr. Sherry Ingraham is back to share of a few of her sunscreen basics. Thanks so much for sticking around. I love your hat, by the way.
Good wardrobe change.
It is. I have to say, too, when we start this process of sunscreens, where do we even begin? Do I need a 30? Do I need a 90? What is it that I need?
The most important thing, and what the American Academy of Dermatology recommends, SPF 30 or higher. That is the most important thing. The second thing you want to look for is broad spectrum. So if it's UVA and UVB, I always say SPF of 30 or higher, and if you can, find one with zinc in it.
Okay, zinc is the better ingredient?
Zinc is a good ingredient because remember, these are physical blocks, zinc and titanium. So they don't react as much in the sunlight. They don't break down in the sunlight. Remember zinc oxide, which was opaque? Well, now it's micronized and transparent. So there are great products over the counter. I love La Roche-Posay. These are fantastic products that are broad spectrum. Also, Neutrogena makes a fantastic array of products that are SPF 30 or higher. Some contain zinc and some don't. Find what works well on your skin. The best sunscreen you can buy is the one you will use, you like.
And La Roche, by the way, available at Target, I believe, right?
Yes, absolutely. Yep. Walgreens, CVS, Target. And you want to always put a shot glass size on for your whole body, which is about 2 tablespoons, which is 1 ounce. So this is 1 ounce of sunscreen, which is 2 tablespoons. That should cover your entire body. And the most important thing is reapply.
And even if you're not getting in a swimming pool, by the way, the humidity in Houston is so sticky, I find myself wiping my sunscreen off.
Right.
Just so because I'm sweating.
That's why I tell people, look for a sports sunscreen. And really the cool things now is look for double duty products. Look for tinted sunscreen. So Elta makes, this is what I wear. I do not wear makeup. I wear tinted sunscreen and then I put a little sunscreen powder on top, which not only gives you another layer, but it also adds to the sun protection. And men can use these as well. They have, Color Science makes fantastic transparent sunscreen powder. So if you're out on a boat, if you're on the golf course, you're sweating off your sunscreen, get the powder. It'll keep you from being sweaty and it'll also give you the protection you need.
I've never heard of sunscreen.
Derek is it's amazing. I know, you just mind blown.
Wow. It's awesome, but this is great. You can carry it in your pocket.
Where do you get that?
You can order it online. Some dermatologist offices sell them, but Color Science is really the leader in this product and they are fantastic.
The other thing is it that timing too? If we know we're going to go, like my boys play baseball, so I'm going to go sit out at the park 30 minutes before I...
30 minutes before, and remember, nothing anymore is, you know, eternally protective. Everything is water resistant now. There's no waterproof. So all products are labeled that are water resistant for 80 minutes after application. If you're getting wet or sweaty, reapply. We tell people if you're out all day, every 2 hours, because the ingredients break down or you sweat them off.
I can just see it now, Courtney, before baseball, you're like, come on, boys, we got to powder your noses.
Oh, listen, let me tell you, definitely. Here's the other thing. I mean, there was a big thing about the sprays a few years ago. Do we use them? Do we not use them? But again, I guess it's just personal preference.
Really, if you can get a cream or a lotion on in the morning, especially on your kids, and then later as you're at the pool,
reapply.
Because, you know, it's a lot harder to hold them down with my kids. I cream them or give them these sticks. These are fantastic. Neutrogena makes these great deodorant-like sticks. You can put them on. Golfers love them because it won't get your hands greasy.
Right.
They're great on your hands. They last all day, but kids love to put them on. And then out by the pool, keep your sprays at hand and respray them.
And that, I'm guessing, you don't need to kind of keep rubbing in with the lotion. This is just
one
on
nice
your
layer, and these are hard to sweat off. They are great. And then sun protective clothing. That really is the answer.
We do need that. When I know that we're going to have some models, real quickly, what are the ages for sunscreen for babies, kids?
6 months and up, you can start wearing sunscreen. Now, you obviously want to keep them in the shade. We all want to seek shade, especially between the hours of 10 to 2. You don't want little kids exposed. You want to keep them covered. But 6 months and up, you can wear sunscreen. But for my children, I have a 7- and 8-year-old. I have found these sticks work great, and they will put it on themselves and have fun with it.
Love it. All right. Let's talk about the clothing, because that's part of it, right? We got to look good while we're staying protected.
All right. So clothing is huge, because UPF is a sun protective rating, basically, and it only lets about 2% of the rays through. So Jennifer's wearing a fantastic cover-up from Coolabah and a wide-brim hat.
I love this hat
because it's a giant sombrero. It's packable, but it gives you protection. What I'm wearing is from Coolabah, also a broader hat. Remember, a normal baseball cap only covers about 8% of your face from the sun, and you're also getting reflected light from the ground, so you need sunscreen and a hat.
And your ears, too. I mean, a normal baseball cap leaves your ears totally exposed.
Absolutely, and men and the ears and skin cancer is very common. So if you look at Brooke over here, too, he's got on sun sleeves. So if you'll show them, Brooke, my golfers and tennis players and my boaters, Brooke is a boater, they love these. They can wear their normal shirts. It's 100 degrees outside. Pull on these sleeves, or they can pull a gaiter up. And you can show them, Brooke, when you're out on the boat, a lot of fishermen will do this, which is great. And I wear these all the time. You don't get hot in it. It breathes with you. And then a lot of times also, I'll tell women and men, if you're playing golf or you're driving a car, people say, why do I get all these brown spots on my hands? And I'll say, keep a pair of these in your glove compartment. Put them on when you're driving, right? Because we see those, what people call liver spots on the hands. They're not liver spots, they're sun spots. But also, if you're a boater, golfer, tennis player, keep these in your bag. They're great.
Wow, I've never seen anything like
and
that.
And I've also seen you say that on Haley Hernandez's report for getting our nails done.
Absolutely.
Under but those UV.
These are things people ask me every day. How do I protect my hands? I wash them all day. The sunscreen comes off. I say, put the deodorant stick on in the morning on your hands, the sunscreen stick, but then keep these in your car, and it makes a really big difference.
Oh my gosh, you learned something new here on Houston Life. Also, you know it's going to happen. The dreaded sunburn, it will happen regardless, and you gave us some great tips. We have that on our Houston Life Facebook page, so make sure you tune in there.
All right, Dr. Ingraham. Brooke, Jennifer, thanks so much for stopping by. If you'd like more information on protecting your skin this summer, just visit AdvancedDermatologyMD.com.